I was young, I had no sense. I bought a fiddle for 18 pence. The only tune that I could play was Over the Hills and Very Far Away. So early in the morning, so early in the morning, so early in the morning, before the break of day. When I was young, I had no sense.
Last summer when we went home to Ireland, we threw a party for our little nieces and nephews, the children of the family. And they sang their children's songs and played their children's games. And we fell in love with our own childhood songs all over again. We're going to sing some of them for you now.
When I was young, I had no sense. I bought a fiddle for 18 pence. The only tune that I could play was Over the Hills and Very Far Away. So early in the morning, so early in the morning, so early in the morning, before the break of day.
One of the first songs that I can ever remember singing as a child was to a snail. In the morning, in the mornings when they left those little silver trails behind them, we used to pick up snails and sing this song to them to try and coax them out of their shell and try and get them to put their horns out. Except we didn't call them snails, we called them shellicky bookies.
Shellicky, shellicky bookie, put out all your horns. All the ladies are coming to see ya.
Shellicky, shellicky bookie, put out all your horns. All the ladies are coming to see ya.
And then in Armagh, where I was born and raised, thanks be to God, the first thing... the first thing you're likely to hear when you're being rocked to sleep would be something like, up the long ladder and down the short rope to hell, King Billy, and God bless the Pope. If that didn't do, I'll tear him in two, I'll send him to hell, he's in white and blue.
There was a song that we used to sing about the sea. And like the snail became the shellicky bookie, the sea was called the Illy Ally O.
There's a big ship sailing on the Illy Ally O, the Illy Ally O, the Illy Ally O. There's a big ship sailing on the Illy Ally O. Hi ho, the Illy Ally O. There's a big ship sailing, rocking on the sea, a rocking on the sea, a rocking on the sea. There's a big ship sailing, rocking on the sea. Hi ho, rocking on the sea. There's a big ship sailing back again, back again, back again. There's a big ship sailing back again. Hi ho, back again. Hi ho, back again.
In the town where we were bred and buttered, as they say, was about 20 miles from the sea, and there was a river flowed right through the town. And on summer evenings, when you had those high tides and the river was swollen, sounds were carried very clearly from one bank to another. And as children were playing on lovely sounding places like Ash Park, Bally Lynch, and the Well Field, you might hear something like this on a summer's evening echoing across the high tide.
Ahem, ahem, me mother has gone to church. She told me not to play with you because you're in the dirt. It isn't because you're dirty, it isn't because you're clean, it's because you have the whooping cough and eat margarine.
That's the low-price bread.
Wallflowers, wallflowers, growing up so high.
He had the measles, he'll never, never die. Call to Paddy Clancy's house, he has no relations. He may tick and tack and turn his back and kiss the congregation. Wallflowers, wallflowers, growing up so high. He had the measles, he'll never, never die.
Call to Tommy Makem's house. He has no relations. He may tick and tack and turn his back and kiss the congregation. Mary the money, she's getting so funny, she won't be left out in St. Patrick's Day. She's sparing the brass for to buy a jackass for to bring her to Mass of a Sunday.
Frosty weather, snowy weather, when the wind blows, we all go together.
Frosty weather, snowy weather, when the wind blows, we all go together.
There was a man of double deed who sowed his garden full of seed. When the seed began to grow, 'twas like a garden full of snow. When the snow began to fall, like birds it was upon the wall. When the birds began to fly, 'twas like a shipwreck in the sky. And when the sky began to crack, 'twas like a stick upon my back. And when my back began to smart, 'twas like a penknife in my heart. And when my heart began to bleed, then I was dead and dead indeed.
Those were the sort of gruesome things that we used to come up with as children. And on the cold, frosty nights, when you'd build a big fire at home, you start telling ghost stories about the banshee and things like that. But children can be very cruel, you know. And we used to do a very cruel thing coming on towards Christmas. We used to go out with big novelty sticks out through the fields and kill a little bird called the wren. Harmless little thing. And we put the corpse in the middle of a holly bush. And we decorated with the ribbons and colored papers and things like that. And then on the day after Christmas, on St. Stephen's Day, we'd blacken our faces and dress up in women's clothes and all sorts of mad things. And go around from door to door singing this song and collecting money for the funeral. And the song that we sang as we went around from door to door was called The Ran Song.
The Ran, the king of all birds since Stephen's day, was cutting the furs, although he was little, his honour was great. Jump up, me lads, and give us a treat. As I was going to kill and all, I met the Ran upon the wall. Up me wattle and knocked him down and brought him into Carrick town.
Growling, growling, where's your nest? 'Tis in the bush that I love best. In the tree, the holly tree, where all the boys do follow me.
Up with your kettle and down with a pan, and give us a penny to bury the Ran.
I followed the Ran 3 miles or more, 3 miles or more, 3 miles or more. Follow the Ran 3 miles or more at 6 o'clock in the morning.
I have a little box under me arm, under me arm, under me arm. I have a little box under me arm, a penny or tuppence would do it no harm.
Mrs. Clancy's a very good woman, a very good woman, a very good woman. Mrs. Clancy's a very good woman, she gave us a penny to bury the Ran.
Penny to bury the Ran, Mrs. Clancy.
It never really sounded like that though on St. Stephen's Day. When you'd wake up in the cold, grey, wet dawn of Ireland on St. Stephen's Day. You'd hear all the different groups of wren boys, some of them singing it as fast as they possibly could to get from one door to another to get more money. But then there was always the ethnic folk types who sang it slowly and deliberately. They never made any money, of course. But they ended up in Carnegie Hall. But you should hear the conglomeration of voices in the street below. And it all sounded garbled and sounded like this.
And then in our land, the north of Ireland, around Christmas and New Year,
We had a carol that was sort of particular to that part of the country for that time of the year. And it went up the long ladder and down the short rope. To hell with King Billy and God bless the Pope. That doesn't do, we'll tear him in two and we'll send him to hell with his red, white and blue.
Devil's dead, some say he's hardly. Some say the devil's dead and buried in Killarney. More say he rose again, more say he rose again, more say he rose again, and joined the British Army. Are you ready for a war? For we are the English. Are you ready for a war? For we are the English soldiers. Yes, we're ready for a war. For we are the Irish. Yes, we're ready for a war. For we are the Irish soldiers. Now we only have one eye, for we are the English. Now we only have one eye, for we are the English soldiers. No, we have no eyes at all, for we are the Irish. No, we have no eyes at all, for we are the Irish soldiers. Now we only have one arm, for we are the English. Now we only have one arm, for we are the English soldiers. No, we have no arms at all, for we are the Irish. No, we have no arms at all, for we are the Irish soldiers. Now we only have one leg, for we are the English. Now we only have one leg, for we are the English soldiers. No, we have no legs at all, for we are the Irish. No, we have no legs at all, for we are the Irish soldiers. Now we are all dead and gone, for we are the English. Now we are all dead and gone, for we are the English soldiers. And now we're all alive again, for we are.